I'm going to describe the steps in a refrigeration cycle. So on the left side, I'm showing a representation of the cycle. And on the right side, I'm showing a pressure-enthalpy diagram. The purpose of this refrigeration is to remove heat from a low-temperature region, transfer it to the low temperature of the cycle. In order to accomplish this, we end up having to put work into the system, and then we have to exhaust heat at high temperature, in this case, exhausting it to the room if it's an actual refrigerator. And to accomplish this cycle, we go through these four steps, where step one, here we have a vapor-liquid mixture, as represented by this point here. The evaporator is transferring heat from our low temperature to the evaporator, which is at even lower temperature. So in this case, for this refrigerant being used, R134A, this is about minus 20 degrees C. So the refrigerated region has to be a higher temperature than that. We transfer heat and we evaporate the refrigerant. To this point, we have a saturated vapor. And we can write an energy balance for this step, and it says delta H is equal to QC. We now take this saturated vapor and we use a compressor, so we put work into the system, and we use a compressor to raise the pressure from low pressure to higher pressure. In this case, we've increased the pressure from 0.15 megapascals to about 0.9 megapascals. And so the energy balance for this step is delta H is equal to W. So this step is assumed to be adiabatic. To increase the pressure of a gas, we have to also increase the temperature because we're putting work into the gas. The next step, going from 3 to 4, we're going to take this higher temperature and higher pressure vapor, and we're going to condense it to a liquid at constant pressure. So this step's constant pressure. Energy balance is now delta H is equal to QH. Removing heat here, transferring it, for example, to the back of a refrigerator, to condense to a liquid at high pressure. This high pressure liquid then, we expand through a throttle, an expansion valve. And the energy balance for this step is that delta H is equal to zero. Assume it's adiabatic because it's rapid. There's no work being done. But when we lower the pressure of a saturated liquid, the liquid evaporates. Because it's adiabatic, the energy to evaporate it comes from cooling everything down. This is how we get the low temperature that we need to accomplish our refrigeration. And so the overall cycle is the running this refrigerant through evaporator at low pressure, low temperature, compressor to raise the pressure, now condenser at higher pressure, and this is about 35 degrees C for the refrigerant we're using here, and then using a throttle to create the low temperature and complete the cycle.